Hi Pisces, welcome to my channel. This is the next 24 hours love connection and general situationship tarot reading session for you, Cancer. This is the next 24 hours. What is the love message and what is the general situationship tarot reading for the Pisces friends out there, okay? One more shuffle. Before I start, I would like to thank you, Pisces, for tuning in. Thank you so much for coming back. Thank you so much for your support. If you guys are interested to further support my channel, check out the description box below because you'll find the details of my Instagram account. Connect with me there, please. Check out my online store, the setting manifestation candles. They are already available. It is free shipping worldwide. It comes with a free reading from me. So type your question, type your manifestation. I will work on the energy and I will get back to you. These candles, we have curated this under the powerful blue moon, October 31st. It's also touched by a Reiki. So it's supercharged with energy, okay? And for guest viewers, if you haven't clicked the subscribe button and the bell, please do it now if you're interested and if you are keen, okay? In today's reading, I will be delivering love notes, love intuitive message, and general situationship energy or message, okay? So let's start from the first three cards on the top. You've got here the Ten of Pentacles, the Eight of Wands. There is some good news when it comes to a relocation, something of a material value over the next 24 hours. It could be a Capricorn, Taurus, or a Virgo, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy, but it is really awesome. Awesome news about money, about the pay, about a rebate, about reimbursement, about something that would kick off and inspire you to do it more. Okay, it could be you're starting a business and then there was no sale and finally you got a sale. So it really is a material gain, a financial gain, a rebate, a reimbursement, a claim, something in favor of you materially. It's a good news. Eight of Wands, it's very fast. For some of you, you will win a travel voucher. Something of a death card. You thought death card in reverse, you could be dealing in with a Scorpio, but you thought it would never happen. For some of you, it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, but there was an expectation coming from you that it wouldn't happen or it's impossible to happen or it's not now, but it's actually happening now, this week. Money gain, material gain, it's good. It's something to be thankful. And it's on your way. It's on your way, okay? It's a blessing. It's a good thing, all right? So that's the first reading. The second reading, this is a love energy, Four of Swords. You're very tired. You're very tired of waiting, thinking. You're reserving your energy, Four of Swords. You're being advised that there are some things in life that you can control, you can influence. But with this love situation, this person, you really have to take a step back because you're going to burn yourself out. There's something of an energy here that the past, they're not very supportive or they're kind of not in with you. So rest up because that would change. It is regarding a commitment. You know, you could be dealing with a person who is interested with you. They like you. They have feelings for you. But they're not really participative in something that you would like them to connect with. It is, you know, it's for some of you been dating for so long, you've known each other, you know, dating, getting to know around the month of May or this year, and up until now it has never reached a point of an outcome. For some of you, you could be in a relationship and things are really shaky. Don't push the button, like don't push it to the extent that they might give up completely. You're being advised to listen to your intuition and to take a break. There's still an interest with this person, but sometimes it is better that you take a break, you take a step back in order to regain the strength and to have a better momentum emotionally and mentally. So I think your person will follow you or will respect or will mimic your energy if you just decided to stay cool, avoid saying verbal, you know, communication that's not really what, something that's not helpful. Don't communicate something that's not helpful, most especially if you want this person. You've got to be clear. If you want this person, if you like this person, don't push them away. Be true to yourself on what you communicate. And if you feel like, if your intuition is telling you they might probably like you or love you, but they're not ready to commit or get married, so be it. Let them be. Let them explore. Let them go. Because if the love is strong, they always come back. Okay? So step back, recuperate. The interest of this person is still there. It's more of how to make it solid or how to put a security or structure towards what you want versus what they want and how to merge it. So listen to your intuition. It's really time to cool off or step back and look after your feelings, your emotion, you know, be realistic on your expectation. You will regroup. I see you regrouping around Christmas time, okay? Like the December time onwards, okay? So that's the second reading. That's a love reading. The third reading, you've got Nine of Pentacles. You're very there is a person around you who's very attracted to you. The World Card, it could be someone from a long distance. And Three of Swords, it could be a cheater, a player. But this is like you're not yet exclusive. Or maybe for some of you, this could be an ex who cheated on you. And now that you're separated, you have more time to take care of yourself. They've been watching you. They've been stalking you. They don't know how to really appear and approach, because this is them. They're in the dark. Look at the eyes. It's like a person who is in the dark and who could not resurface and be straightforward, that they miss you. They like you. They want to approach you. And they're finding the right time, you know, the World Card. It's been so long for some of you. You know, your person felt like it's been so long. I don't know how to be closer or to approach Pisces to be closer in the love energy. They're attracted to you. You have, it is a person who I really feel bad luck. Okay, your person is going through some karma, some bad luck, some not so good energy is around this person. This person could have cheated on you. This person, they're only around you when they need you. Something is dark. Something is dark in this person's energy. And when they think of you, they regret that. They move in the dark. Look at the eyes. They watch you. They stalk you. It could be long distance, but they really feel like when they were with you, when they were connecting with you, when they were in a relationship with you, they're very stable. Their world is better. When you guys separated, disconnected, it became so dark. They don't know how to go out of the light. Maybe this is an addiction. Maybe this is a third party. They left you for another party, and this is what happened. And they could not admit that to you. There's something, it's quite heavy. There's something with your person that they struggle to come out of the light, to reach out and to admit that they, you know, fuck up. Because this is your energy. You're single. You have a lot of stability. You hold the world. Like, you manage your world, your life. It's much, much better when you were with this person. You know what I'm getting from the intuitive today with this three cards reading is that it is showing me how successful you are. And this is a doom gloom. Your person is having the karma. You know, karma is digital. This is them crying in the dark. They made you cry. Now they're hurting. This is you. You're so in love with yourself. You're so like what you are right now, how you become after this. This could be an ex-husband for some of you, ex-wife, but they're not really healthy wherever they are. They might ask for help. They might even ask for money. Nine of Pentacles, the World card. Yeah. Like they feel so embarrassed, but I really feel like it's like desperate call. You know, it's a desperate call. I'm desperate, Pisces. I need to talk to you. I need to be with you. I need you to help me. And yeah, it is quite sad how this person end up this way. It's so dark. While your area, it is so beautiful. It is so healthy, your energy. This person is just shady. It's a dark force. They're like stuck in a dark room where there's tiny light. And it's just so sad. Look at that. So this is your reading. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thanks for being here today. I hope you like the reading. If you do, don't forget to subscribe, to click the bell, and I'll see you soon again, guys. Bye-bye.